Oh man, I've got some crazy hair today. Alright, how's the quality coming in, guys? How are you? Welcome to my 20th live stream. Pretty crazy. For those of you who haven't joined me for a live stream before, what I like to do is read out the username and then read the question or comment and then respond to it. And I often mispronounce usernames, so if I do that, it's definitely unintentional. I apologize just right off the bat. If you try to correct me, I will try to remember your correction and kind of go from there. Okay. Oh, I've got some like silly tab thing that's in the way of my chat. There we go. That's better. Looks like we're doing pretty well for quality. Oh, if you are having some issues buffering, usually just hitting refresh or F5 is enough to fix it. We do broadcast in a couple of different qualities, bandwidths rather. So if you want to drop down from HD to one of the lesser bandwidths, that might make it a little, or make it stream a little bit smoother. Yeah, I think we covered all of the, like, good intro stuff. Oh, from where is everybody tuning in? Oh, I'm getting some comments on my hair. Thank you. I actually did something with it for once. Peter Duffy, looks like Des lost her hairbrush again. I have never been, like, a super, super girly girl. I mean, I like wearing heels. I like dressing up. But I'm really not so good with the styling of the hair. My mother used to make fun of me. Actually, I had a friend in one of my college classes who would joke anytime that I did something like nice, wore something nice, she would say, "Oh, looks like Destinee fell out of the girl closet this morning." Not entirely sure what that meant, except that I don't look girly a whole lot of the time. Ah, we're having some of the the locations coming in. California, San. Illinois, Socialist Republic, Virginia, Georgia, Indiana, Germany is back, Chicago, Kentucky, Arizona. Alessio Baldi, nice grunge look tonight. I did spend a good chunk of my life in the 90s. I guess I'm a product of that generation as well as other, some other time periods. Anyway, Jesse Vanderhayden, America's Dairyland. Another Jordan here. Georgia. I can read, I promise. West Virginia. I'm the boil on America's butt, i.e. New Jersey. Ugh. That's one way to put it. Twin Cities. Alex R. says, where's your puppy? Actually, he is just, like, I can judge distance. That's like 6-7 feet in front of me, sleeping like a babe, which is basically his status quo. Yankee Marshall is from Washington. By the way, I just watched your Helping Hands video response, and holy cow. Like, my eyes were still, like, watering, which...
We thought we were going to be late for the live
stream. Yeah. Dad was watching it with me, and we were worried, oh, shoot, we're going to be late for the live stream. But holy cow. Guys, if you haven't checked that video out, it was, like, ridiculously funny. Lil Taz 74, I see you found a new chain for your 45 charm. Yeah, actually, the chain is the same one, but I borrowed an O-ring from another necklace and made it work. Because I missed having my little necklace. Oh, it looks like I need to refresh because my little chat window is not coming up the way it's supposed to. Okay. Colleen Barnett, I haven't seen Yankee's vid yet. Have to see that. Oh, it's definitely worth a perusal, I would say. I was entertained. I've seen a lot of really awesome Helping Hands videos. It's really exciting seeing how many people have been getting involved. But that video in particular, it had me laughing, definitely. Jesse Vanderhayden, I saw Dad of Dest on someone's Iraq Veteran 8888 shoutout vid. Yeah, he's been on in my videos before, so it's not that he's a complete stranger to the camera. He just doesn't like being in my videos, so He doesn't, and I'm not going to try and pressure him, like, Dad, you have to be in my videos, or something weird like that. I appreciate that he helps out as much as he does, so. Yankee Marshall, I had to stick electrical tape on my son's sport coat to make that video. I was wondering how you did that. I was sitting there baffled, like, he has my jacket. What sorcery is this? That definitely was a big part of the humor for me. Colleen Barnett. I love Joe Fabitz's Helping Hands vid. Very creative. Oh my gosh, yes. I loved that one. And the microphone he uses there? Fabulous. I really enjoyed that video. That was another one of my favorites, I'd have to say. Looking through some comments here. Jennifer Young says, it's creepy! I think that's in reference to Yankee Marshall's video. Okay. Colleen Barnett. Masters 7699... dot, dot, dot. Sometimes my husband and I are on two laptops in one room over and have a 5-second delay. Weird. That is odd. But what I think is funnier is that you're both watching the live stream in the same house from different laptops. That's awesome. I have a habit of, like, with when my brother is in the room or something, I'll, like, pull up my phone and send him a text message, put my phone back as though I hadn't done anything, because I'm a super stealthy texting ninja, apparently. And then he'll get the text, like, 2 minutes later and look at his phone and be like, Destiny, you know I'm sitting, like, 2 feet away from you, right? I don't know what you're talking about! And then I'll just continue acting as though nothing happened and he'll text me back, and because we're both dorks like that. So it's not just me being weird and goofy. It's totally in my family. All right, I'm getting caught up on the comments here. William Prophet, saw some clips from the Eric and Barry Tannerite full auto vid. You didn't look happy. Were you getting tired of waiting or was something wrong? I really had fun the whole day. I didn't have anything wrong except at the end of several hours of being on the range and shooting. I had social anxiety started to really kick in. I do a whole lot better than I've done in previous years, being around lots of groups of people, but after a while I just kind of hit my threshold for how much stress I can handle, and I start, well, not dealing with it as well. But I didn't have a nervous breakdown or anything. I just kind of, at the end of the day, I was starting to get a little overwhelmed, so I took a couple of minutes and stood off to the side and just, you know, kind of collected myself again, and then I was ready to go for the rest of the night, which was great because we ended up having a really wonderful time. Plus, I'd been on the range from like 7 that morning till probably like 7 or 8 at night, and I camped the night before, so I didn't get to sleep until like 3 in the morning. Yeah! Okay, so, I don't know how many of you know this, but I'm mostly kind of a city girl. I've not really lived out in the country. I go camping sometimes, but it's not terribly frequent. And so I wouldn't consider myself to be like a massive, super outdoorsy type person, even though I enjoy and appreciate the outdoors. And so while we were camping out in Georgia, we heard this just like blood-curdling scream, and there are coyotes out where, in Wisconsin, but
I heard coyotes. It was the guys that we were talking with.
Yeah.
They kind of stopped us all and said,
yeah.
Listen.
Yeah. Well, we heard this scream, and I just thought it was kind of weird, and it was kind of quieter at first, but then it kept happening. And so some of the guys that we were sitting around the campfire with were like, hey, be quiet for a second. You know, let me listen to this. But then the howling, screaming noises started getting closer and louder, and there was totally like a group of, I think we counted 4 coyotes that were with, they got up to, how close did they get? Like 50 feet away? They were getting pretty close. So we had ourselves a little coyote hunt. Not that we actually like shot any or caught any, but we all had like AR-15s with us because we're out for the Iraq veteran shoot. We've all got, you know, guns and stuff with us, and we walked all around the fields all in the surrounding area from where we were camping looking for the coyotes, and I had never seen coyotes so close in person. I know I sound really cityfied when I say that, but it's,
you know,
true.
They were a lot closer than 50 feet. They were about 20 feet in front of us, just down a small hill.
Oh yeah, they had been, they like slowly creeped up on us, And there were, like, four of them. They, at first, were at one spot. They approached from one direction, and then they gradually, like, moved closer and closer and closer. And that was, it was crazy, but exciting. But holy cow. And they were huge. There are some coyotes out where I live in Wisconsin, but they're, like, little things. They're probably no bigger than, you know, 40 pounds. But these things looked like the size of dogs. They were, like, really terrifyingly yowling dogs. It was weird, but exciting. It definitely added some interest to the whole trip. And that was a big part of why we didn't get to sleep until late, because we were wrapping up our little coyote hunt, if you will, by like 2 or 3 in the morning. So that was pretty crazy. All right. Colleen Barnett, it's nice to have a partner in dorkdom. Yes, it's nice to know I'm in good company with being a gun geek and just being generally silly. I think that's a big part of why my brother and I have such a great friendship, because we're both total goofballs, and I just can't help myself. So a lot of that you see in my videos. Jade, the most wild animals that we see here are wild boars, and I've never seen them up close, except in a zoo. And on my plate, I was getting a whole lot of warnings from the people that with whom I was camping and just out in Georgia generally. They were talking about how boar attacks are really a common thing. They're not so common where I live. I mean, I've watched that show on Netflix, a couple episodes of it, The Wild Hogs, I think it's called. So I know what wild boars look like, but that's my only like experience with them. So I'm very grateful that they decided to stay away from our whole shooting event. William Prophet, do we get to see the puppy? Maybe, if I can get his like graceless butt over here without knocking too much stuff over. He is snoring right now, so I don't know. I think like 80% of what he does is sleep, and then the other 20% is play like crazy and jump around. Which is funny from an 80-pound puppy. Well,
I had good luck with him yesterday on the treadmill.
I did! Last night, I guess let me start from the beginning. My dog has really short fur, so he doesn't do very well in colder weather. Or in hotter weather, for that matter. But because it's starting to get cooler out, I wanted to be able to make sure that he gets a lot of exercise while he's inside still. Because, you know, I feel bad having him just, like, cooped up when he bullies like to have a lot of, like, exercise running around. So last night I taught him how to run on the treadmill. I was really proud of myself. Because both my dad and my brother have tried it before, but Aries isn't the brightest of pups, so he's a little bit of a slow learner, but with a little bit of encouragement and some cheese, he figured it out eventually, which was pretty funny. He was just like trotting along on my treadmill at like 3 miles an hour. It was awesome. He was a really happy puppy after that, tongue lolling out and tail wagging, and then when I did my run, he was just like passed out right next to me on the right next to the treadmill. It was really cute. I was a proud dog mom. Alessio Baldi. We have a wolves community on the Apennines. I've seen them only from a distance. They rarely come around people. And Masters7699 adds, coyotes freak me out when they start circling you. Yeah, they totally were circling us, and it was definitely freaky. I wasn't scared because there was a group of, like, what were there, 5 or 6 of us, and we all were armed. Most of us with rifles as well as handguns. And some of the people in our group had already been on successful coyote hunts, but for me, that was a totally new experience. Cool, though. It added some, you know, excitement, some out of the norm to the trip for me. John B., I've been meaning to go on a coyote hunt, but I haven't renewed my hunting license. From what the guys were telling me out in Georgia, I guess in that area at least, coyotes are considered a nuisance, and so you can just shoot on sight. John B., I made myself really happy this weekend. I finally worked a hand load for my Savage 10FCPK 308 that shot half MOA group at 100 yards. Nicely done. It's a very precise load. I haven't started reloading. I know. I keep saying, I'm going to get to it, but it's kind of on the back burner right now. Just realistically, it's going to take me a while before I finally save up enough for what I need. I guess I just have some other things of higher priority as far as what I want to spend my money on right now. Eric Kamichik. Here in Brazil, the only thing you can hunt are hogs. I want to go deer hunting sometime, but I haven't yet had the opportunity. Maybe this fall, probably not, honestly, because I would have to have been, like, preparing for it already, and I am not prepared. Not even a little bit. So maybe next year. Who knows? Question for you guys. Who among you are hunters? I see a couple of you, like, you know, boar and coyote hunting. Oh, and do you hunt with a bow or a rifle or shotgun, or what's your preferred tool? Handgun newbie. Dest. First time deer tag in Wisconsin is $5. Oh, that's really cheap. Part of the problem is finding a place where I could hunt, though. Like, most of my friends or family that hunt, they have, like, private property and they have specific, you know, arrangements with whoever owns the property, or they own it themselves and they're really particular about, you know, them hunting it and setting up, you know, feeders and stuff. So that would be the biggest impediment for me. Aaron Manning. Kentucky recently approved hunting coyotes at night. Joe Dean, does hunting my future ex-wife count? Nice. Jade, to be able to hunt here takes a mountain of paperwork. Not worth the headache, really. Dmitry Volkov, I hunt with rifle, bow, and shotgun, depending on what it is. Colleen Burnett, I'd love to hunt, but I've never had the opportunity. None of my family or friends have offered to take me. Frown, playing my fiddle. I have had people now and then, like I have family a couple states over who've invited me, but that means the matter of like driving all the way out there and making sure I have tags for, you know, out of state license for hunting and stuff. So it's just kind of been more of a hassle than it was worth up to this point anyway, but one day it would be pretty cool. Charger 8924. I went squirrel hunting with my dad when I was 8 years old. Ew. I would shoot squirrels, probably, if I were allowed. Not where I live, that's explicitly forbidden. Even if you were to take, like, an airsoft pistol to shoot a squirrel, that would be bad news bears. But I don't like squirrels. I think they're gross. Probably because when I was a kid, I had a room, like a furnished attic bedroom, and there was a squirrel who died in, like, part of the attic, and so it made my room smell, and I had to get my dad to go and clean it out, and it was super gross, and I had a friend who, once my dad had bagged all of the, like, nastiness up, my friend chased me around the house with that bag. It was so nasty. So, me and squirrels, we're not friends. We don't talk. We're not on good terms. Charger 8924, at Master 7699, I killed a possum with an axe. Like a boss. Wow, that's pretty fierce. Jade says, John B., then I guess I'm a pretty uninteresting piece of prey for women, because apparently John B. says that you don't hunt girls, they hunt you. I don't do any man hunting or boy hunting or male hunting. I'm just sitting here on the internets making YouTube videos. That keeps me plenty busy. Savage Henry, tree rat. That's what they look like to me. I may be a little bit biased, but one thing I really, really dislike about rodents is their teeth. Like, just their mouths look really, really gross, especially when they're, like, chittering or chattering or whatever you want to call it. So I'm not big on squirrels or even bunnies. Bunnies kind of creep me out. Some of them can be really cute as long as they keep their mouth shut. But if you ever see a bunny's mouth open, it's like, oh! Because they have these, like, little rat teeth. Creepy! Dmitry Volkov. What about gophers? I think you guys call them prairie dogs. I haven't really seen any in person. I mean, out here, they are indeed referred to as prairie dogs. And I guess the more, like, rural areas of Wisconsin, they're kind of around. But I'm not in a super, like, out in the middle of nowhere place. So I don't really see them. William Prophet. Haven't hunted deer in decades. Killed a few raccoons, but not for food. A couple years ago. And Jason Fry says, my brother got a 7-point buck with a 230-mile Grand Buick last year. Nice. Gosh, I'm so glad I have never hit an animal with my car. I would be upset. And the car would probably be a little bit worse for the wear. Peter Duffy, we have red squirrels in Scotland. They are cute wee things. I don't know. They're just... I don't know. I think they'd still be pretty gnarly to me, but I have a bias. Jade, bunnies kind of freak me out too, although I like squirrels. I think I'd still feel bad hunting bunnies. If someone hunted a rabbit and then made, like, stew or something from it, I would eat it, but I don't know. That'd probably be pretty challenging too. Joe Fabitz. Sorry, I missed the last 10 minutes. Can we start over? Well, you can get caught up after. We just missed talking about rodents, mostly.
Probably not frog.
Oh, Mark Parton says, how about frog legs? And Colleen Barnett says, frog legs completely rock. Yum. I would try them. As far as food goes, I have an opinion of, or a perspective of, I'll try any food at least once, just to have the experience. Because, you know, how do you know you don't like it if you've never tried it? I think the only thing, though, that I would not try would be a rodent. That would be, I don't know, I have like a mental block about that. That just, blah. Blah. No thanks. Do not want. Or like, dog. I'd have a really hard time, like, eating some animal that I would consider to be a pet. Like a dog or a cat. That would. But otherwise... Yankee Marshall, I will not kill anything. I do not have to kill. I take no pleasure in killing anything, not even insects. I think that's a really humanitarian way of, well, I guess, I don't know if you'd call that humanitarian looking at animals, but I still think that's a really peaceful view. Colleen Barnett, bunnies are way too cute to shoot. My husband shoots them all the time and leaves them on the back stoop for me. I can't bring them myself to clean them. I probably have some compunctions with that. Bradley, bunnies have a free pass in my yard. And Peter Duffy asks, how about black pudding? I would try it. If it doesn't, like, smell too horrifying, I would try it. Oops, Scott Messino, sorry I'm late. Welcome to the chat. Lee Nakasone says, rodents, if I were hungry enough and there were nothing left. Yeah, I suppose hunger's the best spice, right? Joe Fubit says, I have bunnies all over my yard, too. I like them till they eat the flowers. I suppose if I had a garden, that would be frustrating, but I won't even pretend I have anything that remotely resembles a green thumb. I'm a plant killer. Alright. Oh yeah, I forgot. Our house has a porch on it, and underneath the porch lives a little family of bunnies, and they've been there as long as I've lived there. So that's as far back as I know. But my dog we've only had for a couple of years, and he discovered the bunnies as a puppy, and he goes nuts over them. He is so fast. If he ever gets a chance to try and chase them, holy cow, like, we had one of those leads that you can put into the yard so your dog stays in your yard, but he can run around a little bit, and little baby bunny came out, and it's a good thing the lead had a short enough lead on it, because Mr. Little Bunny almost didn't make it, because Aries is surprisingly fast. He doesn't look very graceful, you know, walking around the house and doing his silly things that he does, like not remembering how to climb up onto the couch. But when he is running after an animal, it's something completely different. It makes walks in the fall insane because he loves going after squirrels. And it is very difficult to keep his attention. I have to be, like, really adamant about making him behave. Yankee Marshall says, squirrel is not bad, but gamey. Same with possum. Yeah, I guess that kind of makes sense. I like deer, so I don't have a problem with, you know, a little bit of kind of gamey meat, but just the idea of eating a rodent kind of like turns my stomach a bit. Colleen Barnett, onto the topic of cute bunnies. Dave hit a bunny nest with our lawnmower this year. I ended up nursing two back to health, Smitty and Wes. Oh! Well, I'm glad you were able to save the little bunnies. You know, I think I saw something about that on your Facebook. You had pictures of them. They were really teeny, right? They were really cute. Aaron Manning. Pit bulls are great hunters. They have a go-getter attitude. Yeah, I'm sure if I let him, Aries would love to get all the little, like, rodents. He's very agile and graceful when given the opportunity. But I don't want to have to throw out, like, dead squirrel or dead baby bunny or something like that if I don't have to. So, well, he really likes those little animals to chase after, and we have two cats, so I try to keep that natural impulse at bay. Because I don't want him to eat my kitties! Dmitry Volkov, I never understood people who use a 300 Win Mag to shoot deer, but then carry something like a 380. The deer isn't trying to kill you. Discuss. Oh, it looks like some people are having some problems with the buffering quality. Refresh? I'm not doing anything different than I did the last week, and it seemed to work pretty well last week, so I don't know. Be patient. I don't know. Cross your fingers. Sorry. Thor Deshane. I'm sure he'd eat the entire little animal. Very possibly. And then make himself sick, and then throw it up, and then I'd have to clean it that way. Ugh. Do not want. Sorry, I get thirsty. Today it is black cherry, which is delicious, by the way. Alright, let me get caught up on some comments here. Oh, looks like some people who are refreshing, that's fixing their problems. Dmitry Volkov, the Mosin PU sniper makes a good cheap deer rifle. I was just talking about that on last week after the live stream. I went on a Google Hangout hosted by John from Chaos 311 Clarity, and the main topic was rifles, and part of what they discussed was about hunting in particular. And seeing as how I've never been hunting, I just offered, well, ideas, I guess, perspective from a non-hunter's perspective. So it was kind of fun. But I thought that a great cheap bargain rifle for deer might be the Mosin. So it sounds like I'm not far off. Looking back through comments again. William Prophet, I think the handgun thing comes from tales of deer attacking the hunter from time to time. Either that or just an excuse to carry their handgun. Learn something new every day. Oh, some people looks like they're refreshing constantly. Uh-oh. Alright, I am looking through comments again to get caught up. Lost my feet again. Oh, buckets! We're having a lot of lag issues. I don't think there's anything I can do on my end. As far as my connection goes, it says I have perfect streaming. So, I don't know. Colleen Barnett, woohoo! Your face is much better than the green screen. Oh, but Eric Kmicek sees a black screen. Curvin Justice says, I made it. Miss me? Of course we did! Okay. Oh, Jofa Beats asks, how many Helping Hands videos are we up to now? I think the last time I checked, we had 64 videos. And I just had somebody shoot me a text telling me that they were uploading one tonight. So that'll make 65 if my terrible mental math skills are functioning. I am so excited about how the Helping Hands project has been going. It vastly exceeded my expectations. It's wonderful to see people getting involved, people helping out. If you haven't checked it out already, this just, was it yesterday or the day before? I uploaded an update vid, and I went over just some of the prizes. Most of the prizes that have been donated, but there are still a couple, you know, two or three more that weren't on the list of things that I updated. But, oh, speaking of, I have one of those prizes with me. Right here. Look, you. Come here. This little guy! I am not really a huge fan of pink, but when I opened the box with this in it, I just thought it was adorable. And I know a number of little ones who would find this very appealing. So I really hope that whoever it goes to has somebody that this will suit just very well. And if not, well, I guess I could do something else with it. But I thought it was really cute. So that little pink cricket was donated by YouTuber Artisan Tony. Oh, Jodine says, I hate fall. Oh, sad face. Autumn's my favorite season. I really love summer because I love warm weather and I'm not fond of the cold. Not even a tiny bit. I would be okay with like having snow on Christmas and not seeing it any other time of the year. That would be perfect for me. But fall is really where it's at. I love the colors. I had at one point, I was going to school somewhere that was a little bit more, not rural per se, but forested is a better word for it. And the trees were just absolutely gorgeous. All of these like flame reds and oranges and yellows and very pretty. I took like 100 pictures of just trees that year. I'm sure everybody on my Facebook was sick of them. Yankee Marshall, unfortunately, my son would want that. I keep telling him, no pink guns. I don't have any pink guns, but I have seen purple ones that I like. Because purple is, like, my second favorite color. Which, I mean, I'm wearing it right now. It's, like, the main color of my channel. I guess that's not really a big surprise, but... William Prophet, I know one who'd love that. Oh, good. Jade says, aw, a toy gun. It may look like a toy gun, but I certainly would not want to be shot with it. Or with any gun, for that matter. Jennifer Young, purple is the best! Alessia Baldi says, now it's perfect. Mine is going in HD for the first time today. Woo! Ooh, Master7699 says, I love Halloween! Yes, Halloween is my favorite holiday. Absolute favorite. It's just so much fun having the opportunity to dress up as, you know, fanciful or crazy or silly or lovely or whatever is I want. And Halloween has always been like a family project oriented holiday for us. Like some families do the like Christmas cookies together that or I know my mom, sometimes when we were little, would do, like, Christmas wrapping parties, so to speak, where we would all wrap Christmas presents for the rest of the family and stuff. And that was fun, but Halloween is really my favorite. It just gives me a chance to be as creative as I like. And I'm definitely one of those, like, artsy, creative people, which you could probably tell by some of my more, like, off-the-wall videos. And... that ends up being very rewarding for me as far as Halloween's concerned. I'm just reading a comment real quick. Well, oh, I got a comment here, but it got cut off. Let me refresh my window real quick. Thor DeShane, I'm too old and jaded to enjoy the holidays anymore. I had a hard time enjoying the Christmas season specifically when I worked retail, because I worked at a retail store in the mall for a few years. And that was when my social anxiety was a lot worse, too. Actually, that's part of why I took the job, was I thought it would help, like, forcing me to be responsible in a situation that stressed me out. I thought that would help me to kind of get over and learn how to deal with the anxiety. And to some degree, I would say it helped, but I can't remember a holiday season where I worked that retail job that I did not have a massive panic attack, like walking into the back room crying because I didn't know how to handle the world or how to express how I felt or how to deal with that stress level. It was really, it was not cool. I don't miss that at all. I don't really miss anything from that retail job except, I guess, discounts on cute clothes. That was a perk. But, Colleen Barnett, do we get to see some of your costume creations? I've been thinking about it. I haven't made up my mind because I like making zombie costumes because there's so much room for a creative license with those, especially because I enjoy making latex masks out of liquid latex, and it allows for so much customization, you know what I mean? And the that's the problem, is that I come up with some, I and my family come up with some really, like, creepy, freaky designs. And that's fun for me because I like that whole, how the mask turns out as a work of, I guess, kind of art, sort of, because I made it, you know what I mean? But I don't know how well it would be received on, like, Facebook or something, because some of them are just, well, ghastly and ghoulish. I don't know. I have done, let's see, when I did the steampunk thing, not last year, but the year before, I put up a couple of pictures. I'm thinking of developing that costume a little bit more this year, but the stuff that I like, excuse me, I'm sorry, my throat's getting a little bit dry from talking. The stuff that I like ends up being kind of expensive, which makes it really easy for my Halloween budget to be a little bit obscene. I spend as much on Halloween as I do on Christmas. I can't help myself. But I guess I'll think about putting up some of my Halloween pictures. Alright, let's check out some... Master7699. Halloween is supposed to be scary and ghoulish. And Bradley says, steampunk is cool. Oh man, I am so in love with that steampunk aesthetics. It's just such a fun idea to play with. And the point in history that inspires this whole steampunk... style is one of my favorite periods in history too. Like, you know, late 1800s, early 1900s, turn of the century, when the world is learning how to modernize. It's just a really brilliant time for industry. A lot of new inventions and things that were wonderful and brilliant and creative solutions at the time, but now we look back at it and they seem such antiquated, like, clunky creations, like early vehicles, you know, the first cars, or, you know, when flight started. So I really geek out over that whole stuff. Jade, are you going to make a Halloween vid, Dest? You know, Halloween will be really close to a live stream. I think the Halloween falls on a Thursday, so I've been contemplating. Yeah, that's what I've been thinking about. I haven't made up my mind yet because I kind of want to be a zombie again this year. So I might do that in costume. I don't know. What do you guys think? If you guys want to see what my zombie getup looks like. Speaking of videos, I kind of wanted to talk to you guys about something. I haven't talked with only but a couple of other people about this, but I recently was sponsored for a production gig. And so, for video production gig with a customer, and they paid me to create some videos. And, well, one of those videos is going live on Thursday. What I really liked about the project was that I got to be totally creative. And it's very much a Fate of Destinee work as far as like my style of video production is concerned. But I was wondering if some of you might be kind of put off by the idea that somebody paid me to produce a video. Just kind of wondering what your feedback is on that. I mean, the video will go live, the one I'm referencing, will go live on Thursday on my channel. Quilleen Barnett says, "Congratulations, Destinee, so cool!" I'm really excited about it. It just gives me the opportunity to do more stuff that I like doing. It's really neat to have other people enjoying that too, or thinking that it's worth something, you know? More than for just for fun. Jennifer Young says, "Des, it doesn't matter to me. Hey, make some money off your talent." Well, thank you. Thor Deshane says, "Ignore the socialists who don't think you should be allowed to make money on what you love, on doing what you love." Aaron Manning, "I think it's great that your creativity is being recognized." Bradley says, "They say the best thing is to find something you love doing, then get someone to pay you for it." Yeah, that's definitely what I feel just happened this past week. Yankee Marshall, "I've always avoided it because I feel it makes me appear that I might not be completely honest about my opinions." Ooh, here's the best part about this video. It has nothing, it's not a product review. I'm not.
But that's a very good point.
That is a great point. And that's part of what I appreciated about this particular gig is that I had the freedom to do what I wanted with it. And I didn't have to say, "Oh, look at this XYZ product. You should totally buy it." I would feel, unless I really liked whatever the product was, I don't feel comfortable with just making a video saying I like something. Because that's important to me. And Jade says, "I don't have a problem with that." David B., "More ammo money." Yes, exactly. Tony Silveira, "Just don't give up your creative license." That's important to me, too. I like having the opportunity to... Well, it's something that I enjoy doing. And I don't feel like I'm selling out because it's still the type of video that I like making. But I am interested in hearing what you guys thought about it. Because it's not something I've done before.
Yeah, well, you have made video for people, but you show up in the video.
Yeah.
This one is a little different.
Yeah, I don't actually make an appearance. There was no Destinee face in this upcoming video. It's a Fate of Destinee production. I, you know, recorded it, produced it, and everything. But I won't be in it. I guess that's the biggest part of why I'm worried what the response will be. Steve Wallace says, "Everyone needs to make a buck. Kudos to you for enjoying your work, too." Colleen Barnett says, "Destinee is too much character to compromise her integrity for money. Smile. She'll always be Destinee, whether making money or not. I'm all for you being compensated for your hard work, Dest. Keep up." You're going to make me blush. That was really, really sweet. Thank you. It's really nice having friends. Scott Messino, "You got a link for this vid? It will go live on youtube.com/FateofDestinee Thursday afternoon." So it's all wrapped up, but I'm not going to release it for a day and a half. Day after tomorrow, I'll release it. I have a habit of working far ahead in my production list, so I'll be working on maybe 5-6 videos at a time, have a couple videos ready, have a couple videos that I just decide, I'm too excited about this project, I have to do this right now, and people have to see it because it's so exciting for me.
You have 10 videos in the queue, I mean, like, ready to go.
Yeah, I do. I've got... It's nice to know that if I were to get sick or something, that I could still have a video go live and not, like, have everything...
Joe Fitz.
Jofa Beats, can we just skip Wednesday? That's funny. And get right to Thursday. Excellent. Jason Fry, I've always been me for free. What a chump I am. I have always been me for free, too. And some people like it and some people don't. I know I come across as really weird a lot of times, but that's because I am weird. I can't help myself. Oh, man. I was on the phone the other day, and I don't spend a whole lot of time talking on the phone because I'm really socially awkward, and I don't know, I have a harder time interacting with people, and being on the phone just makes it so much worse for me. I never feel like I know what to say. I'll, like, pick up the phone and just go blank. Like, hi, I'm Destinee. So I was having some conversation. My dad happened to overhear some of it, and I got off the phone. He's just like, you're so funny. And I'm thinking I must have said something really silly and not, you know, just off the cuff, because I have a sarcastic sense of humor sometimes. But no, he was just making fun of me for how totally awkward I am communicating on the phone.
You're socially awkward.
Yeah, he's like, you're socially awkward, aren't you? Actually, the words were, you're really socially awkward, aren't you? I was just like, yeah. Here I was, I thought I was being funny and I said something clever without even realizing it. But no, he was just laughing at what a dork I am. But, you know, you get me.
In the nicest way.
Yeah, well, if my family didn't, you know, if we didn't tease each other, I wouldn't feel loved. Colleen Barnett, you've been smooth as glass with Mia, both on the phone and in person. Smile, you're not as awkward as you think. Oh, man, I feel like crazy awkward. It's better. As being in these live streams seems to help a lot because I get immediate feedback. But it's been quite the process. I could not have done this. This idea would not even have been conceivable, like, 2 years ago. If somebody would have said, yeah, you're totally going to talk for an hour and a half with some people you've never met in real life. And just, you know, totally unscripted, shoot the breeze. I would have been like, good one. LOL. This guy's got jokes. Actually, I did have somebody, not even like a year and a half ago, sent me a YouTube PM and said, hey, we host this live whatever, whatever. Would you like to, once or twice a month, have a live show or something like that? So it'd be similar to what I do here, but under someone else's network instead of just hosting it, well, by me, myself, and I. And I couldn't do it. I turned it down because I knew I just couldn't handle that pressure of having to talk unscripted or with anything unprepared, no notes, no idea what the conversation was going to be about. It was all too overwhelming. Jofa Beats, Destinee, don't even think about the fact that we are all staring at you. Don't think of it at all. Nope. Bradley says, anyone have suggestions for a first centerfire rifle for a teenage girl? Well, what do you think about, like, a carbon fiber AR? Like, I've been testing the Wyndham Weaponry carbon fiber. It's pretty affordable. I know MSRP is less than a grand, so you could probably find them around $750, $800 if you're lucky. Or $800 and $750 if you're lucky. What I like about using that rifle is that it's really lightweight. And that's something that I, as a female with tiny little T-Rex arms, have a problem with sometimes is, like, I have a beautiful SOCOM too. I absolutely love shooting it. But if I don't have a bench rest, I can get about 2 rounds downrange before I'm like, I gotta take a break. It's a little bit sad. It's more than a little bit sad.
Nice.
I know I needed to work on the guns. In my family, anytime I do that, generally I have somebody come up to me like, so, why don't you make a muscle? And I'll be like, yeah, muscles. And they'll be like, are you ready yet? You make a muscle yet? And then I cry a little bit on the inside. Just on the inside, though. So that doesn't really count. Eric, can we check? Yes, Colleen. I would love to meet Destinee in person. She looks like an interesting person to talk to. Yeah, some people think so. Some people find me annoying. Because I'm usually, I'm positive, so, and optimistic, so I'm usually in a good mood. More often than not, I'm in a good mood. It takes a whole lot to ruffle my feathers, whether that means, like, irritating me or making me sad or anything. I'm pretty just mellow as far as that goes. But I'm also totally goofy. So if you're not prepared for that that kind of attitude, I've been told I can get on people's nerves. I had a boss at one of my jobs who wanted to fire me or send me to another business or another store within the business because I was too happy. And she said to our store manager, she said, "I just want to sometimes take Destinee in a corner and tell her all of the horrible things in the world so she won't be so excited all the time." And I did not know how to take that. That was one of the strangest comments I've ever had about my behavior, especially in a work environment, ever. So that was a little bit odd. But it works for some people. Thor DeShane, can I buy the SOCOM off of you? No. I'm just going to get a bipod for it, and then I'll be golden. Delta Leader, I met Destinee once. She probably doesn't remember, though. Well, if I knew what your face looked like, that would probably help. And where I met you, that would also probably help. I don't ever consider myself to be famous. I don't have any kind of ego about my YouTube stuff. So it always catches me off guard when somebody recognizes me. And I am almost, like, virtually always embarrassed, like, because I'm socially awkward. So I'll just stand there like, "Cool, you know me and stuff, but I don't know you, but this is cool, whoa." It strips me out. When I'm at SHOT Show and I have like a higher frequency of people recognizing me, I blush less, but I still am pretty awkward about it. It's fabulous. Dmitry Volkov, she wanted to fire you for that? Someone's jaded and dissatisfied. I think it was just a matter of, like, we were oil and water personalities, and I just plain got on her nerves just by being me. I don't know. You can't make everybody like you. So I just try to be myself and hope for the best. Delta Leader, funny you say that. When I stopped you, you seemed a little shocked. Yeah, that was probably why. I never anticipate somebody recognizing me at I don't know if I'll ever get comfortable with that. Just because I'm just like a normal person, you know? I'm not some sort of like movie star or celebrity or something. Oh, we haven't done the Blitz. What I usually do for the FOD Blitz, or what I usually ask from you guys, is to go visit a channel that has, a smaller channel, and I pick out one video and ask you guys to leave a comment on that video, something like FOD sent me, or FOD Blitz, or FateofDestinee told me to check you out, or whatever. Okay, maybe not that. That could be taken a couple of awkward ways. So,
that sounds weird.
Right? So sometimes my mouth says things without my brain finishing the thought. Then that leads to many socially awkward moments. But I have chosen a channel for today.
What did you choose this channel?
I chose the channel Chaos311 Clarity because John has been a friend of mine. A YouTube friend of mine for a couple of years now, and he's just a really nice guy, and he's always been very supportive of my YouTube efforts, so I would really like to be able to give him a little bit of, or share the love from my friends to go and pop by his channel. So the video that I chose for today is, will your AR-15 shoot subsonic 223/556? And the channel, again, is, I'll type it out. Oh, never mind. Chaos311 Clarity. And drop a comment. Something just mentioning me or being creative, whatever. And I will read them off. And they're usually, this generally is a whole lot of fun. I really enjoy this interaction. A lot of you come up with some really silly things to say. So let me go ahead and bring up the YouTube video on a tab over here. I can spell.
Good
Okay. No, he's not expecting this because he has a chat. He hosts his Google Hangout the same night that I host live streams, so he has no idea that this is coming up. Ah, there it is. All right, let's go to the comments section. Y'all are like too fast for me. Great Vid Chaos and FoD Blitz. Neanderthor 66, you've been blitzed. Alessio B, hey ho, let's go. Hey ho, let's go. We're forming in a straight line. We're going to a channel to show the FoD love. The Blitzkrieg bop. Oh my gosh. That might be my favorite comment. That is just really, that's fabulous. That is just fabulous. I have no words for that.
Oh, and if they do like your kind of humor, who'd like John Pizzies.
So oh yeah, John is such a goofball. That is a big part of why I enjoy his channel. Because he's just his, you know, goofy self. And he has great information too. It's just for me it's almost like a perk to enjoying his videos. Like, oh yeah, there's also info there. But he's a silly dude and he just is himself. Alyssa UB also says, subscribed! Excavator EE, I can't think of anything witty or clever. Oh well, FOD Blitz. I have a hard time being witty or clever on the spot, too. Oh, it drives me crazy. My dad will come up with something like just side-splittingly hilarious at the drop of a hat. I don't have that talent. Keeping Peace 2010, complete and utter chaos coming at you from the FOD Blitz. Just subbed ya. Can't wait to check out your vids. Aww. Lutz Mowinski, FOD Blitz from Germany, big smile. Just a few friends of Destiny saying hi. Savage Gunfighter 21, FOD Blitzkrieg. Guns for good. Hey, mate, FOD just blitzed you. Wink. Ew. Savage Henry 762, Destiny Blitz. Should I be your hold on to your AR-15? ... You are about to be FOD Blitzed.
Wow, they're really strong.
Jennifer Young, it's an FOD Blitz! It will never stop! It will continue until you wither under its mighty power! Sorry, that needed to be read in a dramatic fashion. Charger 8921, prepare for the Fate of Destiny T-Rex Army Blitzkrieg. I like need T-Rex Army patches or something, like...
that would be funny, wouldn't it?
I would find a place to put patches if I had a T-Rex Army patch, I'm just saying. Oh man, I updated my, I refreshed my window and there were like a bunch of comments. Peter Duffy, failure still rocks. Well, I suppose that's technically an original comment. Eric K, prepare to be invaded by the FOD army. FOD Blitz! That makes me sound like, or me and my channel sound infinitely cooler than I really am. William Prophet, FOD Blitz. Bo Cantrell, FOD Blitz. Lee Nakasone. And by the way, I'm pretty sure I pronounce that wrong like every time or at least every other time, so I'm sorry. But anyway, your comment read, Yippee-ki-yay! FOD Blitz! Shaka! Drew Johnson, coming through faster than subsonic ammo. Here is your FOD Blitz. Tampa Bay Blaster, FOD sent me. Waffen 40. You have been FOD Blitzed. Sit back and take it. Like a man. 40 Cal Jeeper. Blitzkrieg! FOD T-Rex Army style. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Should I be here? Order of the day? Subbing you. And blitzing too. Hey, that rhymed. Alright, let me refresh again. Mark 38-1969, we are here from the FOD Blitz Army to show you some support. Duh. Masters 76-99, FOD Blitz time. Alessio B. Hi, I'm Marky Ramon, and I watch Destiny's live chats. Don Recepcion, FOD! That was a whole lot of E's. Offensive, defensive, double-ot. I can't hear the rifle firing over the sound of your cursing, because the rifle doesn't cycle. Also, FoD Blitz. That was fantastic, guys. Seriously, that was really, really awesome. Let me refresh real quick and see if there are any other comments. Oh man, that was a blast. Thank you so much for helping out other channels like that. I know they appreciate it. I think pretty much every time we've done an FOD Blitz, whoever the channel was that we blitzed has sent me a message afterward just expressing appreciation. And that is all on you guys. You do that. Thank you. And now, after all of that comment reading, I need some more juice. Well, it's water, but it tastes like juice, so close enough. Eric Kamichik says, I put a patch in my jacket. I need, like, a jacket or a hat or something that I can put patches on.
Because you've gotten a lot of patches from...
I do. I have them, and they just kind of, like, sit around cluttering up my writing desk. Not that you'd even notice that kind of clutter with how much other stuff I have on there. It's a disaster zone. I'll just leave it at that. Colleen Barnett, FOD Blitz is the coolest YouTube trend yet. ... Along with helping hands. Aw, thank you. I really do like being able to get involved in the community, because that is, like, at least half of why I even make YouTube videos, because it lets me make friends with you guys and geek out over gun stuff and food and movies and squirrels. Actually, I don't geek out over squirrels, but we discuss them. I tolerate squirrels. Barely. Unless they're on paper at my range, in which case, they're going down. Yankee Marshall, I use patches to make Dickie shirts look a little less bland when I wear them for concealment. You should have a fashion tips video on how you make that work. I'm sure I could learn a ton. Joe Fabeats, it's the newest fad. All the hip kids are blitzing. Schwell says, sorry, Schwell 11 says, sorry I'm late. Welcome, Schwell! You've missed some fun, but we still have a half an hour left, so welcome. Don't blitz and drive. Colleen Barnett says, don't blitz and drive, Joe. Drew Smoke Johnson, blitzing is a very cool YouTube trend. Greg Womack asks, do you hunt? Oh, we chatted a little bit about that earlier. I have not yet had the opportunity, or made the opportunity, if you want to look at it that way, to go hunting. It's something on my, like, bucket list, I guess, that I'd like to try, but hasn't come together yet. Dmitry Volkov, I hate to change the subject, Des, but would you tell us about your fictional book, if it wouldn't be prying? Well, it's about a female gunslinger, and... it's going to have some elements. Well, what I am excited about is giving it more realistic firearms elements than what I've seen in, like, movies or other books. Like, I will not have my, you know, gunslinger character disengage the safety of a revolver or, like, shooting pistols akimbo or something... you know, something dramatized like that. So I'm excited about that from my own, like, firearms enthusiast perspective. But mostly, more than anything, I want to tell a story. A really big story. So maybe it'll be a series eventually. I guess I'm dreaming big. But that's all I can really share for right now. Lee Nakasone. By the way, Des, they're all good tries pronouncing my last name. I'll rename my username to Hawaii Lee or something. You don't have to do that. I'm sorry, though, for mispronouncing so many times. Yankee Marshall says, I had to go eat dinner. Repeat everything from the past 20 minutes. Stuff, guns, and stuff. I think that's a pretty good summary. Oh, and we went over to Chaos Clarity's FOD. We went to Chaos Clarity's video on subsonic, will your AR-15 shoot subsonic 223/556, and we blitzed it, and it was awesome. I think it was pretty much, that was a good wrap-up, right? The 20 minutes?
Someone else added this.
Oh, apparently I've got another comment to read over here. So let me go refresh the my window so I can get caught up. Reading this, I sound ridiculous. Well, if you guys weren't aware that I'm a total dork before, well, I'm glad to have removed all of those doubts. Viking Knight 2012. That was by the Manchester Wizard. Thanks, making me sound like a goofball more than I already make myself sound like a goofball. But yeah. Viking Knight 2012 says, the call has gone forth, and you have been FOD blitzed. Joseph L. Dean says, I'm late to the blitz party on account that I was clipping my toenails. Gross. Joseph L. Dean said that. Yeah. Colleen Barnett, when are we thinking this awesome story will be available for purchase? I want to buy a signed copy. Oh, man. I know. I have to get to work on it. I need to finish my other book first. Hey, I wrote, like 2,000 words mostly for my own stuff last night. So that was pretty cool. I'm working on it. Aaron Manning, the dorkdom has been properly officiated. Take a bow, Des. My pleasure. You're quite welcome. Peter Duffy, Joe should be in it as a sheriff or a donkey seller. Aaron Manning, epic, like Hunger Games. I did read that series. I enjoyed it. There are still a lot of things that I'm working out as far as the way I want to tell the story, and I have a couple of ideas of plot threads that I will be including, but it's kind of like I'm weaving a story web. It's an interesting process. I enjoy it because it's very creative, but it's difficult creating an entire world with its own history, its own culture, its own religions and social inequalities. But I'm enjoying that project. I love being able to, I love that I found a way, there we go, I can speak English really, to bring my loves of history and enthusiasm for the shooting sports and my love of reading and fantasy novels and adventures and boil them into one hopefully delightful stew of fiction novel. But we will see. It's a big project for me. Charger 8924 says, how is the weather up in Wisconsin? It's getting chilly and I don't like it. It's really not that bad though, considering that it's October, which many years that's when it starts snowing. So at least it hasn't started snowing, but more than a couple dog walks have been cold enough for me to see my breath, which makes me a little bit sad. But what's funny is I mentioned that my dog isn't super great with cold weather, so he shivers when I take him outside once it's winter. But I don't want to be one of those dog owners that puts, like, little goofy sweaters or something on their dogs, especially because, you know, he's a bully and he looks kind of cool. And I would just feel awful having him dressed in some, like, ridiculous sweater. But at the same time, I don't want him to be cold. So. Camouflage. Yes. That's what I need. I need to put him in some sort of, like, tactical vest. Like what they have for canine units or something. I don't know. Then I think I could justify putting him in some sort of, like, dog clothing. I won't even get, like, Halloween costumes because I don't know, I feel bad.
When's your Helping Hands thing done?
Oh, yeah, Bradley just recommended, get him a tactical vest, Des. I'll have to look into that. Oh, or one of those service dog vests. That might work really well, because then I can put, like, stuff in it, and he would feel like he had a job to do. His breed seems to like having some sort of, like, function, yeah. For those of you who are keeping up to date on the Helping Hands project, there are still a few, a couple more days. Thursday is the last day, so Thursday, October 10th. Holy cow. That's already this week. That's crazy. Where has the time gone? So, if you are interested in producing a video for the Helping Hands, there is totally time left. So please make a video promoting two channels that have less than 5,000 subscribers in the next couple of days, or ask one of your friends to make a video. It doesn't even have to be like with a camera. You could just make a video slideshow with, you know, text on the screen. Anything helps. It's been noticeable. So if you have a couple more days to get involved, and plus getting involved can make you eligible to win a couple of really awesome prizes. So good bonus there. Alright, looking through. Steve Wallace, you need to get your dog a sheep coat so people think you are walking a sheep and not a dog. Then it won't look so silly. Unless, of course, you think walking a sheep is silly. Perfect solution! All my problems are solved. Alright, reading through a few comments here. If you haven't checked out the update video that I posted, it's top five tips for how to help or how to grow a successful YouTube channel. And I have both the Helping Hands Project giveaway prize update included and some tips to help grow a YouTube channel. So I have what I hope to be some helpful information for for smaller YouTubers especially, but any channel or a channel of any size really can benefit from the advice that I've put together. Apart from my own research and apart from what other YouTubers have found to be successful with their channels. And then there are also the prizes listed. So if you haven't looked at it, check it out. Also, if you haven't stopped by, check out thearmsguide.com. We have just brought on another writer, so I'm pretty excited about that. I guess having people want to get involved with a project that's so important to me really just tickles me. It's wonderful to see. Yankee Marshall, I have found it helps to pretend you know everything and treat your audience like crap. Brilliant! Oh, Mitchell Burke says, G'day from Australia, mate. Just joined. Do I need a note? Mm-hmm. Yes. No. I don't know. Welcome to the live stream. Oh, for those of you who have joined late, or maybe you don't catch it some week or something, immediately after the live stream is over, you can check out the recording of the event on new.livestream.com/FateofDestinee. But I also take the video, the recording, and post it up on youtube.com/FateofDestinee generally within the week. I generally get it up within that week.
Is your last week's video going live today, or what?
Last week's live stream will go live later today. So, I have to write a description for that. But, so if you miss any part of that, you can check out the live conversation after it's live on YouTube. And a lot of people seem to still be pretty pleased with that. I just like trying to give people as much opportunity to join in or to catch up on what they missed out on. Just because I've had some people ask for that. Jofi Beats. Jet Migraine is going to do an in-depth news report on the 5 top tips vid. LOL. Fantastic. I look forward to his feedback. Or to his report.
I expected that to be in black and white. We had a black and white feel to it.
Dad says he expected that video to have more of a black and white feel to it. And I get where he was saying about that. Especially with the... Oh man, I totally love the trench coat, by the way.
Well,
that was fabulous. Yeah, it was well done. I agree. But it did seem to be kind of something that would be a black and white type video. Okay. Old Dirty and Smelly. Are Aussies allowed to say the word gun? Yeah, from what I understand, shooting sports is not exactly looked upon in a friendly manner out there. Lee Nakasone. Time goes up into the sky and across the cosmos. How poetic. Jofi Beat says, thanks, Dad of Destiny. Delta Leader 71 says, I'm a gun guy, but into aviation. Charger 8924. Any All Things Destiny vids on the way? I haven't with the giveaway. I've been working a lot more on that. And then with traveling, I still have footage from the Iraq Veteran 8888 shoot in Georgia that I haven't posted. So that, the All Things Destiny has taken a little bit of a... I don't know. I'd have to look. I'd have to see if I have something that I could just put out there, you know, for the fun of it. Delta Leader 71. I think your tips were good. I think my channel is just too much of a niche audience. Never will be a big channel. Big channel, your channel doesn't have to be big in order to be successful if you're having fun, you know? That's always been important to me with my videos, is to keep them fun for me. Because I would get so burnt out with how the hours that I put into YouTube, both with the making videos and researching and coming up with new ideas to keep them creative. It's a lot of work. So if I didn't enjoy it, and I didn't enjoy the interaction that I got with you guys, I think I would have stopped making videos a while ago. And if it stops being fun and it turns into something different, I can't imagine how that would change for me because I enjoy it so much, but I think if it ever stopped being fun for me, that would be my cue to stop making videos. But I can't see that happening, not for a long while anyway. 2 seconds? Oh yeah, I've had a couple of people say that they want to see more bloopers from me. There's plenty of footage of me doing silly things.
Yeah, this is
but
like an hour and a half of bloopers.
I know, right? This is a complete, like, 90-minute chunk of me being a goober. And you guys very gracefully putting up with it. Okami Jigoku. Heyo! Sorry I'm late. I was busy repairing a trailer. Well, welcome! I hope your trailer repair went successfully. Or was successful. Jofi Beats. Bloopers are always fun. Jade Des. I hope you never stop being fun for you making videos. I hope it will never stop being fun for you making videos. That would really be a loss. Aww. Aaron Manning says, more silly Destiny! Oh, Charger 8924, I saw you in a Guns of the 111th vid. Yeah, I believe I saw that. Oh, yes, actually, I know I saw that, because Peyton was at the same shoot in Georgia. Oh, alright, sorry, I just wanted to sit a little bit differently. After sitting in the same spot, my knees start to ache, because apparently I'm getting old or something. Oh, William Prophet, puppy never got close? No, he has been, like, out like a rock this entire time. I bet you if I said his name, he would wake up, but I doubt he would even, like, come over. My dog has this weird way of sleeping with his eyes open, and then he'll start dreaming, and so his eyes will move back and forth or, like, seem to be looking all around, but they're never focusing on something. Like, I'll sit right in front of him and watch his eyes go, which is totally bizarre and more than a little bit creepy. Alessio Baldi, we want to, yeah, we want to drown in your silliness. Ooh. Oh, be careful. Jofa Beats, I'd whistle, but he won't hear me. Yeah, and William Prophet, best let sleeping dogs lie. I see what you did there. Yeah, usually when he's sleeping, he's, like, on me, like, on my lap or something. I have pictures from when he was, like, a tiny little puppy, and he would sit, like, close to my stomach, and then I'd have the laptop, like, just beyond him, like, at the edge of my knees, trying to type above him. And then he'd roll over, and, like, his paws would all over the keyboard, helping me type. He still tries to do that, but now he's just too enormous. Like, just the size of his skull is the size he was as a puppy when we brought him home. So, he, like, will generally, like, sit on my hip. And then gradually he'll crawl over. And then, like, it'll be his front legs and his head on my lap. And then he'll crawl over some more. And then he'll, like, flip upside down. And I can get no work done when he does that. In part because he's super adorable. And I spoil him a tiny, tiny, tiny bit. Greg Womack, what is your favorite handgun? That is such a difficult question. I guess it's a little bit of a toss-up. I really enjoy shooting a 1911. Just most 1911s I've shot, I like them because the ergonomics seem to suit my hand well. I like the 45. I like shooting the 45 ACP round. Like the feedback that it gives, and I like how accurate I can be with it. But I have developed a pretty strong fondness for the CZ-75, especially the BD Police model. I shoot well with it. I think the most accurate that I shoot with a 9mm is with that, with a CZ. The ergonomics are just really just difficult to beat for my hand size anyway. Okami Jigoku, it's a toss-up between the 1911 and CZ-75, isn't it? You're good. I award you 20 internets for that. That was spot on. It's funny that some people know me that well. Bradley, I'm having some frustrations with my 454. What's wrong with it? I'm not shot. That's a 454 Casull, right? That's the round? I've not shot that before. Joe Dean, I just bought a Cold War edition CZ on Gunbroker last week. That's cool. Okay, looking back through comments. Delta Leader 71, 1911 is my favorite. Best fit for me. That is also part of what got me excited about the shooting sport. Because I had done some shooting, like with a BB gun as a kid. And I did a turkey shoot when I was 7. Which, I won the turkey, but I was a little bit afraid of the shotgun after that because I didn't have it close enough into my shoulder, and so it kicked, and it surprised me. But I didn't really get super jazz about the shooting sports until my dad had me, or let me shoot one of his 1911s. And after that, that was pretty much it. Now I like shooting a whole ton of stuff, but 1911 still I've got a little bit of a soft spot for. Eric Michik, CZ-75s. What about the CZ-85? Are they good too? I have not shot the 85. I've shot the 82/83, which I like very much. It's kind of like a Milsurp answer to like the James Bond Walther. Because it's blowback. It looks a little bit similar. The blued version does anyway. But it's cheaper. It's fun. I just like military-style firearms just in general, or military-style weapons in general. Like, I've got a fondness for... like, that's why I like the K-bar. Anything with a little bit of history to it, it makes it more than just a tool. More than just metal and wood or plastic. It has more significance to me, and that makes it more interesting, just from my standpoint as a collector and an enthusiast and a lover of history. By the way, I know we're getting close to the end of the live stream, but I wanted to take a minute to thank you guys. It's a lot for you to, sit down and plan to chat with me, for some of you, for the entire hour and a half. And I really appreciate that you take that time out of your schedules to talk with me. I think it's just really cool that anyone would want to just shoot the breeze with me, especially for an hour and a half. I appreciate it, and I enjoy the interaction. I think it's really cool how I can talk right back and forth with you, too. So it makes it feel more like I'm having... It makes me feel like I'm having a conversation with a bunch of friends. And that's why, even though as awkward as I am and as, like, silly as I can be, I still enjoy these live streams, every one of them. And I look forward to them during the week. So thank you for taking that time to sit here and talk with me and having patience for my stuttering and my rambling and any other wonderful, awkward things of just being me. Jade, I'm a night owl. I'm awake for most of the night, and this way it's time well spent. Oh man, that's right, you're in Germany. Well, plus two extra thanks for you for staying up late. Same for anybody who has to stay up late, whether you're working third shift or in another country or what have you. Jodine, well, since we're friends, can I borrow 20? Yeah, definitely. I'll just need to grab a 20 spot from you first. Is that cool? Oh, 20th live stream, by the way. How did that even happen? Craziness, in a good way. I didn't think that we were gonna keep going with them for so long, because I didn't think there'd be enough interest, but I thought, what the heck, we'll give it a shot, and, well, you guys keep tuning in, so I'll keep conversating with you. Paul G, makes the hour and a half worth of housework go quickly while listening. Thank you. My pleasure. Steve Wallace, you do realize your pops is paying us all to talk, don't you? Yes. Just kidding, we all love it. Kind of wish it was 2 hours. Oh, thanks, Dad. Lee Nakasone says, in Hawaii, we can't have NFA weapons, AR and AK pistols, called assault pistols, and a ban on pistol mags over 10 rounds. And I hear from local friends that there will be a yearly registration fee of $80 per firearm. Extremely bogus. Holy freak sauce, Batman. That's ridiculous. That's so, like, restrictive. I can't even wrap my head around that. Jade says, 20th live stream, so that's 5 months? Is it five? That's pretty close to 5 months, yeah. Jeez. Wow. I hadn't even thought about it in that way. Just the fact that it was 20 weeks, you know, that there were 20 of them. But that's pretty cool. Jodine, and I love to clip my toenails to the sound of your voice. Murr! Awkward turtle. Colleen Barnett, Jodie, you're gonna make me barf, dude. Jade, Colleen, should I get you a bucket? You guys are silly. Bradley, I own no firearms. They all got lost. Wink, wink. Nudge, nudge. Oh man, I just got a bunch of comments all at the same time. Lee says, time to go. Aloha, Des. And look forward to next week. By the way, season 4 premiere of Walking Dead on Sunday. Yeah! I have a number of friends who are very excited about that. Jake Lohman, in Illinois, we can't have NFA items unless we go through the loophole and we have to have a FOID card just to say we can have a firearm in our possession. I hate that idea. William Prophet, I really enjoy it. My littlest looks forward to it, too. Aw, that's awesome. It really, I don't know, gives me warm fuzzies when I know that people are sharing, like, my videos or my content or watching live streams with their families. That's really special to me. You have a bunch of people. Oh, yay! Walking Dead! Yeah, I'll get around to it eventually. I have a really great good guess that if I start that series that I'm gonna want to watch a whole bunch of it, and then I'll get nothing done, which is not cool. So, I don't know. Gosh, I don't even know when I don't really take vacations, because anytime I have a vacation, I'm really just traveling and working. One day, I'll just, like, buy them all, and I'll watch them nonstop for, like, 3 days or something ridiculous like that, and then I'll be all caught up. Bradley, you going to dress up for the Walking Dead new season? Maybe not for the Walking Dead new season, but I might dress up for Halloween. I always dress up at least around the house. Like, I'll get in a costume and I'll hand out candy. on Halloween when I had young enough family members, I would go out trick-or-treating. But now it's just kind of like, why is this grown adult woman walking around in costume collecting candy from strangers? That's weird. So I don't have a good excuse. Although, a good number of my friends are, like, having babies now, which is, by the way, really crazy for me to wrap my head around. But that seems to be, I guess, the thing to do after finishing high school and starting lives as young adults. Maybe I can snag one of their kids just to be like, look it, we're trick-or-treating! Joffy Beat says, tell Aries we all said goodnight and that he is a party pooper. Aries, Joe says you're a party pooper. He didn't even twitch. Colleen says, do you give out cartridge-shaped chocolate and gun safety brochures? Oh gosh, that would be hilarious. Well, we are out of time, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope to see you next week at new.livestream.com/FateofDestinee. And for those of you who missed any of the bits, I will be posting this recording back up on YouTube, probably by this time next week. Bye, everybody. Have a lovely evening.